Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today's topic is going to be completely in English because a few of our subscribers DM me personally asking to do at least a few videos now and then in English so that those who don't know the language will also be able to watch these videos. So I decided to do this one in English, and today's topic is going to be somewhat of a science fiction genre. We have seen a lot of movies where a spaceship or a UFO comes, lands on our planet, and strange looking creatures come, creates chaos here. What if I say this is not a fiction anymore and could be a reality very soon? Today's topic is going to be somewhat related to this. Before we get into the topic, those who have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe here. Let's get into the topic. In the recent times, scientists have picked up a mysterious signal from outer space. Later, they discovered this actually came from a planet that is 4.5 light years away from our planet, which is called Proxima Centauri. We're going to see about this signal and why this signal has gained so much of an attention. This particular star is not very bright in nature, so even though it's comparatively close, it's difficult to locate the star with an unaided eye. If we have a closer look, this is how Proxima Centauri would look like, which is very similar to our planet, and this star is actually only 10% larger than the Earth. Scientists say that the location of this Proxima Centauri is the optimal location for survival because this is not too close or not too far away from our solar system, which makes the temperature of Proxima Centauri optimum for survival. So in the case that the water exists on this star, there is a very real possibility that it is in liquid state, which makes it possible for aquatic life forms to exist. And there is also a very close possibility that there are civilized life forms on this star from whom we might have received this mysterious signal that we are yet to decode. So how do scientists actually figure out if the signals are really man-made or if it or alien-made or if it is being emitted from a natural science? So these signals are like radio waves. They have certain frequencies in length. The signal that we picked up from Proxima Centauri is 982 megahertz. The regular radio signals, for example, the FMs that we hear in our cars are within the 100 megahertz range, like 92.7, 93.5, around that range. This is like 980 megahertz, which is too long. So with this, the scientists have come to a conclusion that this is not from a natural source or not being naturally emitted, and this is actually artificially made. Researchers and scientists believe that this might be the form of communication that is existing between the developed civilizations of the interplanetary communication. And in the case that if this is really a message from another planet or another civilized world, we should be able to decipher it, but it will take some time for us to decode the message that we have received now. Receiving a message or a signal from another planet or a star makes it very exciting. This news is very exciting, but this is not new because our planet Earth, scientists from our planet have also sent such a radio message out into the outer space, hopefully in establishing a communication with an alien life form. We keep talking about this receiving a radio message and sending a radio message into the outer space. What does this message actually contain and how does this message actually look like? This is all very hypothetical. So in order to make it real, let me explain how this radio message is actually coded and how it might look. Okay, so the message that our planet Earth has sent into the outer space, this message is called an Arecibo message, and this message contains about 1679 digits exactly. Okay, as far as the construction of the message goes, imagine a rectangle of 23 into 73 squares that is coded with information about our civilization in binary codes. Okay, so this message is split into parts. The first part of message is the number system that is being used in our planet. The next one is in the purple form, which is a key to decode the rest of the message. So if a life form is able to read the first part of the message and are there, and if that species is able to decode the purple part of the message and go to the next part, then it means that that life form is civilized enough in order to establish a communication with us. That is the basic intent of this radio message. So the next part of the message contains all the basic elements that our Earth contains, like hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and phosphorus. So all the natural elements that is needed in order to start a life on a planet. The next part is the green part that contains the DNA construction of a humankind. Okay, then there is this red part of the message where the human figure, the silhouette of a human, is encoded into this message so that the species from the other planet or the other civilized world would know how the species on the planet Earth would look like. And then the last parts of the message contains the location of the solar system in the universe And the final part of the message contains the location of the lab from which this message was sent. So NASA has been tracking this Arecibo message ever since it was sent, and currently it's 25,000 light years from Earth, which is near a star called M13. If the message that we have received from Proxima Centauri is such a message, like how we have sent into the outer space, then it would take some time to decode this message in order to understand what has been encoded into it. So as we continue to search for life forms on the outer space, our Milky Way galaxy is actually 100,000 light years in diameter. So if there is actually a life form that is existing on the other side of our own galaxy, then it would take like 100,000 light years for our message to reach them, and another 100,000 light years for us to receive the message that is being sent from them. So the best hopeful scenario is that the aliens have already tried to contact us millions of years ago, and the message is on the way to reach us. So then possibly we might be able to receive this signal. So if Proxima Centauri people are actually trying to contact us, then there might be a very possible scenario where they try to reach our planet in the next decade or so. So what we thought as fiction, like aliens invading our planet, might not be a fiction anymore and could be a possibility soon, which is all very exciting, but it might not happen in our lifetime. So let's see what are the interesting messages that they bring to us if our scientists are able to decode the message from Proxima Centauri. Those who have not subscribed to my channel, do like, share and subscribe. Bye guys.